Yep, it was all about amor, amor, amor for Jennifer Lopez and Ben Affleck with a fairy tale wedding weekend fit for Bennifer. Welcome everybody to Entertainment Tonight.
You know what? We are going to make you feel like you were a guest. Mm-hmm. ET's Brooke Anderson is on the ground in Georgia with all the I Do details.
Thanks, Kevin and Nichelle. Yeah, everybody here in Savannah is still buzzing over Bennifer's I Do's. The guests basically took over the entire town for the 3-day event. And how do we know that it was a super fun, exhausting weekend? I mean, check out Ben's face on Sunday night when it was all over. Waiting for tonight. Fireworks, an all-white dress code, and J-Lo's 20-foot veil. The 3-day wedding event did not disappoint. And a source tells ET, Ben and Jen remained cool, calm, and collected through it all. J-Lo was stunning in a white Ralph Lauren gown, topping off the gorgeous look with a dramatic sheer cathedral-length veil. Ben matched his bride wearing a white tuxedo jacket, black trousers, and a black bow tie. After the ceremony, the newlyweds posed for photos and videos all over the 87-acre property. Their 5 kids also joined in, coordinating in all white.
And will the kids have a hand in what?
Of course, of course. Can't have it without the kids.
I was outside Ben's very private estate as the excitement started to unfold. Here's a timeline of the wedding events. Matt Damon and his family were spotted arriving by private plane on Friday afternoon. On Saturday, we spotted luxury auto company Audrain Motorsports getting here around 2:45 with a car under wraps. 3:15, 2 catering trucks entered the property, and at 4 o'clock, Old Savannah Tours entered with some trolley buses. 20 minutes later, officiant Jay Shetty left the Perry Lane Hotel in Savannah. And of course, security has been working around the clock. Guests at the Perry Lane Hotel were greeted with this goodie bag with a JB inscription on it. On Sunday, the couple capped off the weekend with a brunch and barbecue. Who wasn't there for the big I do's? Well, all the exes, of course. Jen Garner was spotted out at a Sam's Club in her home state of West Virginia with her boyfriend, John Miller. J-Lo's ex-husband of 7 years, Mark Anthony, was in Miami saluting workers at a marina there. And her most recent ex, A-Rod, was also in Miami where he hit the gym. The weekend wedding comes just over a month after Bennifer tied the knot in Vegas and more than 21 years after Jen told us this.
I love outdoor weddings. I would, you know, when I got married the first time, because I'm hoping there will be a second time one day.
Will you get married a second time?
I think so. Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, I believe in marriage. Even though mine didn't work out the first time. Not the point.
But the outdoor weddings are great.
Yeah, they are.
Back in Savannah, Ben's longtime friend, movie producer / ice cream shop owner Stratton Leopold, made this prediction to ET.
Of course, they're together again forever.
They complement each other so well. They're both family-oriented, which is crucial, I think, to any relationship. And they have that down.
Stratton, a Savannah native, produced 2 films co-starring Ben, 2002's The Sum of All Fears and 2003's Paycheck.
I mean, what's in our future?
You know, I don't know.
Met Ben in 99 in Montreal. Work ethic was great.
He also met Jennifer around that time during an audition.
We auditioned Jennifer for the general's daughter. We didn't cast her. That's when I first met her. And then, of course, when I did the second picture with Ben in Vancouver, we did Paycheck, and she was there with us on set.
All these years later, Stratton is still getting the scoop. This time, as the owner of his 103-year-old family business, Leopold's Ice Cream.
Ben would come here, still does. Ben loves our butter pecan. We usually sit on that on a bench up front there and just talk. They come in here with the kids, and the scrum of publicity. It typically doesn't happen here.